Get to a servo ASAP because fuel prices are going to jump. This is a look at unleaded prices as we go to air. Not a single capital city will be spared from pain at the bowser. The average price in Brisbane sitting the highest in the country, followed by Melbourne and Adelaide. Petrol on the cusp of nearly $2 per litre in most states. Jesse Burns is following this story for us. Jesse, good morning. This is going to hurt drivers.
It certainly will, Sarah. And over the past 6 months, Australians have been largely shielded from the rising cost of fuel thanks to the federal government. That ends today. You may remember, if you cast your minds back to March early in the year, fuel was around $2 a litre. And at the time, the federal government, led by Scott Morrison, decided to cut the fuel excise. And that was to ease the pressure and the cost of living. The price of fuel simply too unbearable for drivers at the pump. And as I said, it ends today. And the current federal government says it won't continue with it. Jim Chalmers, the federal treasurer, says it's too expensive. The cut to the fuel excise is too much of an expensive exercise. Up to this point, it's cost the government around $3 billion. So two questions remain, Sarah. How much and when will it happen? Well, it's not expected to happen in the next day or so. There is 700 million litres of fuel currently in the system, so that price or that cost won't be passed on just yet. But how much will it happen? Well, experts, or how much will it cost, should I say? Experts say it's going to be around 25 cents extra. So, Sarah, the message is, fill up now.
Welcome back to the show. Well, it's been the small thing providing some relief to Aussies at the bowser for months, but from today, that all ends.
The federal government opting not to extend a cut to the fuel excise, meaning petrol prices will all but certainly rise. Well, for more, we're joined by Peter Currie from the NRMA. Peter, good to see you this morning. We've already noticed that some of these prices are starting to rise.
Oh, absolutely. I mean, Sydney, Brisbane, Melbourne and that, our four biggest cities are way too high this morning. They're about 10 to 12 cents a litre higher than they should be. We don't know why, but we do know it's unacceptable. So even before we tackle the excise, we now have this problem.
I think we've got some figures that we're going to have a look at here. But you're talking about, here we go. So there's the low, the average and the high in each market. Why are Brisbane and I think Melbourne so high there?
Yeah, and you can add Adelaide and Sydney to that list. Yeah. Now, none of those prices should be in the 190s. There shouldn't be 190s averages anywhere in Australia today. Yet here we are, the day before the excise gets reintroduced to the wholesale price, not the retail price, and we are dealing with this very challenging issue. Also, remembering that we are running into a long weekend for extended parts of the country and school holidays.
The government warned that they'd be watching the prices, and they've already gone up, so they're just not even scared, these operators.
Well, we'll have to see what happens when this excise gets introduced to the wholesale price on Thursday, because what we want to see is obviously the oil companies doing the right thing. If the prices jump on Thursday, we know in addition to these issues, something big is probably.
So you're saying as we go to air this morning and as people wake up, they're on the way to work, the price of petrol should not be that high?
Absolutely not. And to put it into context, oil prices have dropped $60 a barrel since June. The wholesale price in Australia has dropped 52 cents. It's done nothing but go down. There is absolutely no reason why these capital cities are in the 180s and 190s.
How do you explain it?
You can't explain it. And that's something the oil company should be doing today, not me.
So just price gouging for the sake of it?
These prices are way too high and they need to come down. And they should have started coming down at the start of this week because we know that at some point in the next couple of weeks, prices are going to jump 25 cents a litre.
It's incredibly disturbing for people out there who are struggling to pay basic bills at the moment. And if there's, my worry is that what happens Thursday? What happens next week? What happens in 3 weeks?
Well, we believe at the NRMA, having looked at what happened when the excise was cut, that it will take about 6 to 7 days for the prices. It should take 6 or 7 days for the prices to go up in the main capital cities, probably 2 to 3 weeks in the regional and smaller cities before we see those increases. And that is what the ACCC needs to watch really carefully.
It's the last thing Aussie households need right now.
Yeah, it's really just going to add to their bill, isn't it?
Yeah. Thank you, Pete. Good to see you. One thing providing some relief to people struggling to make ends meet is, of course, the fuel excise. But from today, that all ends. Petrol prices, we've been told by Peter Currie from the NRMA, are already way higher than they should be. And nothing can be done about it, Matt.
Well, look, we're going to remove the excise relief will be ended tonight, I believe, and so that will increase petrol prices. But we've got to make sure we have the money to service our budget, to make sure we fund our roads in the future, so we can't keep this going forever. The best thing we can do as a country, though, is invest again in developing our own oil and gas resources, so we're not as vulnerable as Europe has been to changes in commodity markets.
I think that's a fair point too.
It is, but I really want to make sure that consumers are protected and we're not seeing the big oil companies profit off this. And when the ACCC says it's going to keep an eye on it, that is the absolute minimum that average Australians will be expecting. And we all know we're coming into October, it's going to get worse at Christmas because it always, you know, dials up whether the market is calling for it or not at Easter and Christmas. So I really would expect the ACCC to come down on a ton of bricks on anyone that is, you know, using this to inflate prices
further. I agree.
Further.
And I feel like Australians are being burned right now. I mean, we've got interest rates that are going through the roof.
Yeah.
You've got power bills that are going through the roof. Now the petrol.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, it is a tough environment, just finally, Matt.
It is, Carl. We need to invest in energy. That's what we need. You want to bring the price of those sort of things down, you've got to increase the supply. And that's why today myself and 9 coalition senators will move legislation to remove our ban on nuclear energy. Mm. We have the world's largest uranium reserves. We should be using our energy resources to deliver more energy for the Australian people and bring down their cost of living.
Well, and all those pesky Czechs are buying up our coal mines. I mean, imagine being that smart.
Well, no one else will. So
exactly.
Someone's going to see an opportunity.
Good to talk to you guys.
Also making news this morning, cheaper fuel prices will soon be no more, with a fuel excise cut set to end tonight. Petrol prices could rise by at least 20 cents per litre in most states and territories. John, fill up now, but we were hoping this is going to be extended. There was no promises from either government that this is going to be extended, but it's just not going to happen.
It was never going to be extended, and it probably shouldn't have come in the first instance. The reason they brought it in, 20 cents a litre, which obviously helped some people, but not a huge amount, it's cost us, the taxpayer, $3 billion for this 6 months at 20 cents a litre less. Let's be honest. The only reason it was brought in by Josh Frydenberg at the time was he knew the election was coming up,
right,
and it was another attempt to buy some votes, which failed miserably and cost the country $3 billion. It didn't work. They lost the election. The current government is saying it's too expensive. We can't afford to keep bleeding $3 billion by taking 20 cents off a litre. So it's got to come back. So, yes, what you just said is exactly right. Fill up now, because tomorrow it's going to be 20 cents.
It has been sweet relief for some, though. There's some anecdotal reports around this morning that prices are already rising.
Yeah.
And we shouldn't be seeing that for at least a week or more.
Absolutely not. And the price of oil per barrel is actually quite low at the moment, relatively speaking. So it is just a false economy. I mean, we've been paying what we think is cheaper petrol for no good reason. Like John said, further down the line, we will feel it out of the hip pocket somewhere else, you know, through the tax. But, I mean, it is just a small amount, and it's pointless. The prices of the barrels are already going up. Last week, I already noticed that it had gone up at least 10 cents.
And to put it in perspective, yes, $2 a litre is expensive, but you know, in America and in Europe, they're paying around $4 a litre.
$4, yeah.
So to put it into perspective, we're still going up.